operate for both Mauritius and India. We are also trying to party recognition of the foreign signatures by like China, Taiwan, and other countries. There is an agreement, international agreement, which you are trying to work out. This is the in scenario, the scenario of the India PKI, the public key infrastructure. Let's take a particular area which we are talking about, the digital signature for revolutionary banking. This is what it is. First is the introduction, you will see that, trust and legality, the current banking environment, possibility of stress on online application, digital signature mitigating the challenges, benefits of digital signatures to banks, and so on and so forth. These are the various topics which I'm going to cover. Obviously, why do you use a digital signature? Why do you use the internet? Is a fast, very easy, convenient. You can perform the transaction anytime, anywhere. In fact, the customs department allows you to use your digital signature so that you get more time to that. And they also, if you are going to pay your custom duty using your digital signature, they give you, I think, 5% or 10% discounts on the custom duty which you are going to pay. So it's sometimes advantageous for the customer to use it up. So it's very important for us to promote so that the whole activity becomes much more revolutionized and we can perform the transaction much easier, a much faster way. Is it basically, on the other hand, the government or financial institution is challenging to manage growing consumer base leading to the increasing transactions and turnaround time. That was the reason the income tax department today says that there is a centralized income tax processing unit has been created in Bangalore. So if you file your income tax papers through the net and through digital signatures, you don't have to worry about it. Everything is automatically taken care of. Your process, your report comes to you. If money has to be paid, they automatically send you the check to you. But if you are using only internet to fill up the form and not digitally signing it, you have to send the printed output of that particular thing to the, what is it called, the income tax department located in Bangalore before 30 days or something like that. Physically, you can go and stand in the line on the 31st of the particular month and file your income tax papers, etc. This is what it is. I think the income tax is going to take further steps. For all companies and other things, income tax has to be paid using their digital signatures only. They do not allow manual filing of the income tax papers. I think that's one of the rules which are going to do. I expect in next couple of years' time, income tax department is going to come say, all of you have to pay through the net only using your digital signature. That's the next step, which most probably expected to take place very soon. As far as the banking sector is concerned, the Reserve Bank of India has, I think, in 2002 or around about the time, given the guidelines, and one of the guidelines which says is that you have to, whatever mechanism which you are using for internet transactions onto the internet banking, onto the various banks is concerned, you need to have four fundamental principles which has to be applied: identity, authentication, integrity of the data, and non-repudiation. Somehow, banks has not followed the last factor. They followed only first three factors, and then rather first two factors only. They started with the user number and password and asking them to change the password every 15 days. How many of us remember the 15 password, the complicated password? So finally end up writing in notes, this is my password, and 1st of January this one, 15th of January this password, so again 30th of January this password, etc. We used to write that. So that's what happened. So most of the people has to write, and this is very clear. And each of the banks has to create an infrastructure of keeping the names and the passwords, and you have to give a message and saying that you have not changed the password, please change the password, and on so forth activity. It's a lot of processing activity which was cost. I think if you look at the amount of processing which banks does for identity of individuals, the cost of transaction expected around about 8 rupees plus or minus this way. That's what used to cost them to do the processing of individuals on the internet banking is concerned. But still, the banks are happy to do that. They invested the money. They have CA, the information officers which are performing the jobs. But that's all gone down the drain. Because the bank's job is not to do that. The bank's job is to provide financial services to the customer. Outsource the security of the particular operations which can be confirmed by doing the responsibility, the ownership to the individual who is doing interaction with the banks are concerned. That's basically needs to look at it. That's where we have come. And then the bank subsequently recognized there is a problem. There are a lot of problems are taking place in internet banking. They suddenly came up two-factor authentication. That's what has come recently about a couple of years back. So you need to have two-factor authentication. And the banks have been sold by a number of varieties, vendors, OTP is a bit wonderful solution. One-time password is a beautiful solution. Why don't you use it? And it has been marketed and being used. So you want to do transaction, you send a message, and you get one-time password, use the transaction. But that doesn't provide you security for the transaction which you want to perform in the net. It doesn't really give the thing. And sometimes you also come across the Citibank and all those things, you're operating virtual keyboards. These are all really doesn't give the type of trustworthiness that you are looking for, okay, right? But whatever may be it, the Reserve Bank now recognizes, though of course the guideline says that non-repudiation is essential factor, but majority of the banks do not follow the non-repudiation factor because the OTPs doesn't give you a non-repudiation functionality at all. So unless they come to the digital signature, they will not fulfill the recommendations of the Reserve Bank of India, which they have given 2 years back. Similarly, the same recommendation guidelines has been forwarded by the Reserve Bank of India, which is the basically controls the whole banking operations in this country for mobile applications. Again, mobile. You got a lot of very interesting application. I don't know any one of you uses M-Check. Okay, right, whatever it may be. Again, you have issues, the problems, and which needs to be tackled for us to have a very secure transaction. For the banks, it's very convenient because they lose only 10 crores of rupees and make a profit of 20 crore rupees. I think it's a pretty interesting proposition for them to do that. So they continue to dwell until the customer forces them to change, to provide you more secure and trustworthy transactions to using, adopting the standard or latest methods and technologies and do that. But whatever it may be it, the problem, the most of the banks, we're now going for the internet banking because it reduces the cost. As far as the individual concerned, is a very fast and speed ways of doing the transactions concerned. So I can transfer the money from one account to another much faster. Digital certificate is equivalent of the identification card. Not really, it's much more than that because it really identifies you, the authenticates you also, this are. Passports are driving license. In fact, passport today uses the digital signatures, which has been signed by me by the passport officers. So we have another chain which we have created for signing the passports. So all the passports which are recently being issued has been digitally signed by the regional passports officer. We have another chain which we have created for that. So the passports are going to be digital and smart passports with the, you will always contain digital signatures of the certifying authority, in this case, my signature. Okay, it is uniquely established as the unique identity of the individual when the person interacts or transacts with the net. Digital signatures was the public key infrastructure. As I said, for whatever be the reason, when the Information Technology Act was enacted, it used the PKI structure. That's what the structure is quite popularly used at that particular point of time. So we have a very, very interesting, the Information Technology Act was a specific technology-oriented act in 2000. That's what happened. Obviously, the United Nations have come up with UNICITRAL, the general procedures which has to put. From that particular point, we copied some of them, and then we introduced the word electronic signatures in the modified act of the Information Technology Act 2000. So use the word electronic signature. Some people confuse it with XML signature. It's not so. XML signature doesn't give you the same trustworthiness as digital signature. There are certain issues which are related to XML signatures. But whatever be it, PKI is the only technology currently recognized by the Information Technology Act, and you will get all the law protection, the Indian law protection, if you use only the signature which are issued by the CAs which are recognized by the CCA. That's what it is. Currently, we are using 1024. In fact, we issued an order in 4th of April 2011 saying that we will be shifting over to the key size to 2048 from 1st January 2012 and the hashing algorithm from SHA-1 to SHA-2 from 1st January 2000 to be in compliance with the rest of the world. The reason is that we found out that the algorithm which you use, 1024 key, is going to be broken up in next few years' time, maybe down the 11, 5 years down, or 5 to 10 years down the 11. So we don't want to get caught in that particular mechanization. So we chose to switch over the key size, similarly SHA-2, and we expected this will have a life of at least 20 years. So we will be safer, and meanwhile, we'll come up with new technologies. So we from say 1st January 2012, we are going to use the 2048 key size and SHA-2. So your private key will be 1024 bits and your public key will be 1024 bits. I understand the old micro DOS platforms do not accept, process this particular key size, but most of the last few years, four or five years back, machines does accept the key size and processes, etc. There is no problem. And I also understand the proxy or SIM cards which you are going to use the mobile phone has the capability of processing 2048 bits as well as the SHA-2 algorithm. That's possible to do that. So most of the applications, the Reserve Bank of India application, intra-banking applications, the remote transfer applications, all those are being transferred to 2048 and the SHA-2 algorithm. Similarly, we also find out the e-procurement applications and other applications will be switched over by 31st December 2011. This is very compulsory. They're legally bound to do that so that each individual. And you also recognize the digital certificates are not given for a long period of time. They're given a really short period because we do not know whatever it is there. In the case of handwritten signature, we somehow feel forever it remains, but it varies. But whatever be the reason, we don't change our signature. But in the case of a digital signatures, the certificate is gone only for 2 years in India. We have a limit of 2 years. So if you take a certificate today, it will be valid for only 2 years. It's not more than 2 years, okay, right? So we are, but some people do have a complaint saying that too short periods are, we are paying too much money. So because of that pattern, we may increase the life of this certificate from 2 years to 3 years, but not more than that. Because you have to make sure the algorithms and procedures and processes are secure, because the whole life and the act does not give you non-repudiation functions. So we have to be extremely careful. So we are not going to go beyond 3 years. The maximum period will be 3 years. That's what it is. And the key size will be. We are also going to give you a permission for encryption mechanism and escrow system using the KM particular mechanism, the asymmetric technology which you use. We also issue SSL certificates for your websites, etc. Remember that particular thing. It provides legal sanctity for online transactions of 2008. That's what it is we have today. This is the scenario of the information technology. Let's look at the banking environment. Why banks are more important? First is the challenge is when banks are performing the transactions, they need to have the confidentiality information. If I'm transferring 1,000 rupees or 1 lakh rupees or 1 crore rupees, should be confidential. The bank is not supposed to share this information with anybody. So first fundamental thing is the confidentiality information.